Hello. In this video, we're going to talk about CSV files and how to manipulate them, open them in a text editor, how to open them in Excel, and how we can change delimiters, and finally, how to save CSV files. So the easiest way is to just jump right in and open a CSV file. Here we have a few different CSV files in this folder. CSV files are simple text files, and when you receive a file, they can have an extension of CSV or TXT. They're simple text files, so you can open them with Notepad. Here's a pretty standard one. This CSV file contains leads, and the first row contains the column headings, so we know that the first column is going to be customer ID, followed by first, then last, first name, last name, address, apartment, city, state, zip, etc. And you can see that each column is separated by a comma, hence the name comma separated values. When we import this into a database, each row will become a row in our database. At the end of each row, there's a carriage return line feed, which is invisible, but it's there. If it were not there, the data would just run into each other, and it would look something like this. So we know that there is a carriage return line feed present, but invisible. As you can see, it's a little hard to read data in CSV files in a text editor, especially if you have a lot of columns. So easier way to work with them is to open them in Excel. We open Excel, go to the folder that we have our files. At first you're not going to see them because it's set to filter the files and just show us Excel files. We change this to all files, and now we see every file in the folder. Double click on our text or CSV file, and we present it with the text import wizard. We follow this with a couple of screens, and it will import our data, our CSV data file, into Excel. First, we have to specify the file type, which is either delimited or fixed width. In our case, it's delimited with commas, so we select delimited, and on the next screen, we'll select our delimiter, which is comma. So, delimited files can be delimited using tabs, semicolons, comma, space, or other delimiters. Other ones, very popular one, is the pipe character, which you can see on your keyboard. It's the shift of backslash. Pipe character is a common delimiter because it's not used in everyday typing or conversation, where comma is used commonly. So we're back to selecting comma here, and as soon as I hit select comma, you can see that it turns our data into columns, and at this point I can just hit finish, and here's my text data imported into Excel. Now I can make changes here to my data and then save it back into either Excel format or CSV format. Now when we save data into CSV format, comma, as we said, is not the best delimiter. I can give you an example. We open our text file, and let's say Charles here entered Charles, comma, Mary. He put his wife's name into the data. Instead of saying Charles or Mary, he puts Charles, comma, Mary. And we save that. Now if we go into Excel and import the same file, select our comma as the delimiter and finish, you will see that the record for Charles went out of alignment. Instead of Charles, comma, Mary landing in the first name column, Mary got pushed to the last name column. As soon as Excel sees a comma, it figures it's a new column and it pushes it to the next column. And we see this all the time with comma. It's not a very reliable delimiter. So we can change our delimiter, and a lot of files that you receive in CSV may have other delimiters. So you need to either ask the sender what the delimiter is, or take a quick look inside the file using your text editor to actually view the delimiter. So if you're working with delimited files, often enough, you are going to want to change your default delimiter to something other than comma, preferably pipe character. And you do that in your Windows machine. This is a Windows 7 machine, by going to Control Panel, to Region Settings, Region and Language, and then from there you select the Format tab and Additional Settings, and here under List Separator, change the comma to pipe character. Hit Apply, OK, and OK, and close Control Panel. Now if I open that same file, which was delimited by comma, I can save it. Go to Save As, select my folder, I'm going to give it a slightly different name, and I'm going to select for the file type, I'll select comma delimited. However, since I've changed my comma into pipe, when I save this, say yes to this, what I expect to find now is, here's a new file, I expect it to have pipe as a delimiter. And sure enough, instead of comma we have pipe, so this makes for a more reliable CSV file. In direct results telemarketing, we use CSV files quite often to import into the system as leads. Leads are sent by various call centers or website operators to our clients using various CSV file formats. And with direct results telemarketing, you can easily open CSV files and using drag and drop map them to our system fields. And that's covered in the next video. I hope you found this useful. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel so you are notified when new videos are added. Thank you.